Hey everyone, Scorch82 here, and welcome back to another episode of Back of the Box. So, let me ask you all a question. What do you get when you combine the stealth aspects of games like Thief and Splinter Cell with the environment of games like Bioshock and the combat mechanics of games like Condemned Criminal Origins and Skyrim? Well, let me tell you, you get Dishonored. It's a new game that's brought to us by Arkane Studios and published by Bethesda Softworks. And it follows the story of Corvo Atano, who is the Lord Bodyguard of the Empress of the city of Dunwall, which is kind of modeled after like Victorian London, kind of around the era of the Industrial Revolution, during times of plague. And the story follows, and we'll see in the intro sequence as I kind of go through it here, the story follows the basically the framing of Corvo with the murder of the Empress. And the story focuses on his quest for vengeance by becoming an assassin with the aid of several outside groups and a entity by the name of the Outsider. So it follows his course from basically escaping from prison and getting out and meeting up with this underground resistance and pretty much just developing his skills and gaining gadgets and getting powers to become stronger and figure out ways to exert his revenge on those that have wronged him. It follows heavily on games that have RPG aspects, and I mentioned it's got mechanics that are similar to Thief and Splinter Cell. So if anybody that's ever played Thief by Eidos, the missions are... The gameplay is actually mission-focused, so it's singular missions that have kind of a sandbox feel to them. So you're progressing linearly in the story, and you have pretty much any means at your disposal to accomplish the mission. And at the end, you're rated based on how well you did, whether or not you were stealthy, or you picked up enough treasure, or you found enough secrets, you know, that kind of thing. And where it kind of differs from Thief is that Thief actually had concrete objectives that you had to complete or you would fail the mission. In this particular game, you don't really fail objectives other than like dying and having to restart, but pretty much you get whatever's at your disposal to accomplish the goal, kind of like Splinter Cell. So the game features many gadgets that are kind of like the technology of Splinter Cell. It's just kind of more industrial type items, you know, that you'll see as we kind of go through here, see some of this. The gameplay mechanics, as far as like the fighting and stuff, we'll see some tutorials and whatnot. I'm actually fairly impressed. It reminds me closely of a game called Condemned Criminal Origins, which came out for the Xbox 360 around the time it was launched. I didn't get so into that game, but the style of combat is very reminiscent of that, as well as games like Skyrim. So it would suffice to say that it's actually pretty close to that, given the fact that it was made by the same publisher. So let's go ahead and just jump right in here. So this is a game that features an autosave type mechanic here, where you can do new games and play multiple playthroughs. But it saves your progress automatically as you go through, so if you start a new game or load up another save, it overwrites the autosave, so you have to make sure to kind of keep your own saves. I've played through about an hour or two of it already, and gotten through the first mission. So you can choose what missions that you want to play as you progress, so you can replay and try to do better. You can look at some of the mission stats for things that you've done. So in this particular first round mission, I killed 10 people and had 5 bodies found, and I actually caused quite a bit of chaos. You get bonuses for not being detected or not killing anybody, and as you progress through the game, the outcome and the further stories are changed based on your past behavior. So it kind of rewards you for doing things in a more creative and not just a Rambo type way. And it's also one of those games that really enhances the replay value by making it so that you can't get everything in one playthrough. So you sort of have to go through the game multiple times in different ways in order to actually unlock everything and see everything it has to offer. The interface reminds me a lot of Batman Arkham Asylum and Arkham City. I'm not really sure why, it just kind of does. It just kind of has that feel to it. There's several options that you can pick through. Most of the things I've never had to change. You can change your crosshair style, how it moves, the opacity, you know, standard type configurations for any game with a HUD. Any game that requires sort of aiming with the sticks has invert capability, so if you go under controls you can change the sensitivity and you can invert the y-axis, which I always do. I don't know why anybody wouldn't, but that's just my opinion. Aim assist, which actually kind of helps in this game. I haven't found any time where it hasn't been very helpful, but a lot of people tend to get tired of using that after you've played a game for a while and get used to it, because it sort of ruins your mojo. And then any system or audio options that you want to change. Subtitles are not enabled by default, so you can choose to have them only on the main dialogue, or you can choose to have it on all speeches, which I'm personally a fan of, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Let's see. Control scheme is kind of done on a type basis where they change certain buttons based on preference. Type A is actually fairly common. The game features two methods of attack, where you have your primary attack is your sword, and you have your secondary attacks, which can be anything from like a crossbow to magic to a pistol. So that's kind of your secondary weapon. It's a ranged weapon. So based on your preference or whatever it is you're doing, you can equip that in your left hand, and you kind of have a dual attack mode, so that's kind of nice. You can use and sheath weapons with a square button. The triangle is used for adrenaline kills or leaning. We'll see a little bit more about that in the control tutorials about how to do that, entering sneak mode and all that kind of stuff. Any game that employs any sort of method of stealth sort of requires that you have some handle on stealth and sneaking action, you know, that kind of stuff. So that's not so much to show for the options here, so let's kind of just jump out, and I think I've spent enough time rambling, so let's go ahead and jump in. We'll play the tutorial mission and see if we can make it through mission one. Let's go ahead and start a new game. Presumably your objectives are relatively the same through each difficulty level. It's just normally whenever you have a game that's got different difficulty levels, they pretty much change the balance of the damage the enemies do, the damage that you do to enemies, and your healing item powers. Stealth and combat are moderately difficult. Default enemy damage and potion effectiveness. Increased challenge for experienced players. Enemies inflict increased damage and are more perceptive. So any game with stealth, harder difficulties, enemies are a lot more akin to what you're doing. I've even found that on the normal difficulty, they're pretty perceptive. Overwrite your autosaves, that's fine. Overall, for the amount of time that I've played this game, I'm already pretty impressed with it. The mechanics are pretty good. The control is very fluid. The voice acting is very well done. The graphics are superb. I have a couple of complaints about actually getting into combat. It's probably one of those things that actually just takes some getting used to. So I'll go ahead and read this caption. You have just returned from a journey of several months visiting the other nations in the Empire to ask for aid in dealing with the rat plague. You must deliver their diplomatic response to the Empress, whom you serve as Lord Protector. So we're returning to the Empress.
Corvo, if only there was someone else I trusted to send, so that you could remain near. But there is no one else. And the Spymaster was right to insist that I send you. The plague has taken so many, and we must find a cure. When you are near, my heart is at peace. Emily and I will count the days until you return. Hurry home, and bring good news.
Steady hand. That's it. Watch it.
Cast off line.
Casting off. We're away.
Use R to look around.
Take us straight to Dunwall Tower. Lord Corvo has news for the Empress, and we've come a long way.
A long way to bring bad news. The sailors say there's a curse on us. Black magic.
Superstition. For all we know, there's a cure for the plague by now.
Maybe. We live in strange times.
So one thing I've noticed so far in kind of months, dealing with the control scheme is that the sensitivity, even though it's all the way down for me, is still relatively sensitive. And I've never been a fan of games like this that use control sticks. This is a game that's available for Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and PC. So in case it's not obvious, I'm playing it on the PS3 right now. Is that if you have a game that requires the use of control sticks to, like, alter your camera and your vision, the sensitivity is actually really important. And for me, having it less sensitive is better because I tend to make less subtle movements with the control stick, and that's just by nature of how I always play. It's been one reason why I never did like first-person shooters or even some third-person shooters on the consoles. So that would be one complaint that I have. Left stick to move around. It's pretty standard as far as control scheme in first-person type games on consoles. You use the right stick to alter your camera so you can strafe and sort of emulate mouse movement. You can interact with characters.
Fewer ships moving along the river now, with the plague and all.
So this is Dunwall. We sort of see a little bit here. That's kind of a gross port right there. Beware deep water, don't drown. No good.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Her Majesty is waiting in the pavilion.
Corvo, you're back! Will you tell me about your trip, please? Were there any whales? Wait! Let's play hide and seek first. I'll cover my eyes and you hide. You have time? Mother's busy talking to that nasty old spy master.
Alright, so you get the options to either go away or play with Emily. So let's go ahead and go on.
Okay, here we go.
This is pretty much like accepting the tutorial.
Let's go! Come on!
So the game is full of objectives that you can complete, and this is one of your first experiences with the alternate objective mechanic here. And this is actually one portion of the game that I thought was really good, is I like games that incorporate tutorials sort of into the story, whether it's like minute or not.
I'll hide my eyes and count, and at the end of the countdown, I'll try and find you. Okay, I'm going to count to 10. Find a place to hide.
Alright, so it's pretty much your tutorial into stealth mode. So you press circle to enter stealth mode, and that's like sneaking around where your footsteps make less noise, and now we have to find a place to hide. So we can hide behind this thing right here. Six, as stupid as that
seven,
sounds.
Eight, nine, ten. Here I come.
And if you hold the triangle button, pressing left or right on the stick will allow you to lean. So if you hold it down, you can lean out. And she can't find us. She doesn't try very hard, actually. It's kind of creepy, like you're watching a kid doing that, but...
Here?
Sort of a nice addition. You get to incorporate it into a little bit of goofing around, which, as most people play games
okay,
like this, like, you have to goof around. Some
other can see you too.
Otherwise, you won't catch everything. So, pretty much now, you just go out. Be like, I win! So I thought that was a nice touch.
Follow me, Corvo.
You can push the left stick in if you haven't noticed the prompts on the screen in order to sprint, which will become in handy later when it comes time to getting away from enemies.
Welcome home, Lord Protector. Stop moving, Campbell.
I'm gonna go ahead and skip some of these cutscenes in the interest of time. Looks like Campbell.
Think you'll get your own squad after she'll see you at once.
Thank you, sir.
I believe so.
Looks like a fun game, huh? Or maybe just a design on the table?
They're sick people, not criminals.
We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens, and we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty.
Nasty old spy master.
Corvo, 2 days early, full of surprises, as usual.
Snivelly little man. Hello, lady.
Everyone seems scared because of the rat.
It's a fair wind that brings you home.
I'm glad you're
here.
Hello.
What news have you brought?
Give the letter. One thing I wish they would have done.
The cities had dealt with this before, knew of some cure. This news is very bad. We're at the breaking point.
One thing I wish they would have done is added a voice to the main character, which I don't think they did.
Are you okay, Mother? You seem sad.
Yes, don't worry, darling. Mother is fine. Wait, where are the guards? Who sent them away?
Oh, shit.
Mother, look! What are they doing on the rooftop?
Oh, shit.
Emily, come here.
Oh, you get the combat system intro now. So press R1 to attack with your right hand, L1 to attack with your left hand, if you have a power or weapon equipped. Oh no, press and hold R2 to block incoming sword attacks. Perfect timing puts enemies off balance and opens them up to lethal counterattack.
Emily, get behind me!
Die.
Look out! Corvo, thank you. If you hadn't been here... No more! Not again!
Mommy!
No! Get away from her! Corvo!
Mommy!
Get away! Corvo!
That's unfortunate.
Corvo. It's all coming apart. Find Emily. Protect her. You're the only one. You'll know what to do. Won't you? Corvo.
Ward us all. Look at what he's done.
Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young Lady Emily, traitor?
Her own bodyguard. Ironic.
I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Peg him.
And that's the prologue. Very interesting lead into the story. Of course, it's very cliche that they show up and you're the only one standing there. Like, oh, it's your fault. It's just like what happened with Witcher 2, which was a good game, so it's not really a fault on the way they brought the story in, but... You know, how else can you kind of build up to that? It probably could have been a little more involved, but you have to build the story around exactly that premise, so it's not really, didn't really need that much lead-in. Anyway, so 6 months have passed since you were accused of the royal spy by the royal spymaster of murdering the Empress and conspiring to abduct her daughter, Emily, the royal heir. Now locked away in Coldridge Prison, the time of your execution draws near.
Final chance, Corvo. Sign the confession, and let me give you the rights to put your spirit at ease.
That's enough for now. Get out. Let's give the man some time to think. Corvo, the Empress is dead. Her daughter Emily is hidden away, and no one will ever know the truth.
Yes, unlucky you. Tomorrow you'll be executed, but it's for a good cause. This country needs strong leadership now, someone to guide the weak. And that's where we come in.
There was nothing personal in this, even though you almost sank our plans. But it turned out well. You were in the wrong place at the right time, and someone has to take the fall. Goodbye, Corvo.
Guard! Take him back to his cell.
Man, fuck that guy. It's no wonder why this guy wants to get his vengeance. But too bad we're in jail.
You should eat, Corvo. This meal comes from a friend.
Oh, man. We got a health bar now. Look at that. Alright, so here's our cell. You can look outside and kind of see that there's something going on over there. Anyway, let's go do this. Eat our food. Who we are is irrelevant right now. Just know that we have faith in you. Here's the key to your cell. Once you're out, head for the prison's interrogation room. Take the explosive there and plant it on the outer door. When the bomb goes off, run. Make for the river and lose yourself in the sewers. You'll find some useful gear stashed there. One of the guards will leave a weapon just outside your cell. And good luck. We need you alive and well for what's to come, a friend. Get up. So here's kind of an introduction into actually being able to interact with things, like picking things up and stuff. The one thing I don't really like is that some items you can pick up, you don't really know you can pick them up until you get within range. So it's not always obvious that you can pick things up. So it does employ a little bit of you sort of have to pay attention.
Killed the Empress and abducted her daughter, Emily.
So it's an occasion.
Right.
Sword in hand, assassinate an unaware enemy by pressing R1 or approach an unaware enemy from behind and hold R2 to perform a non-lethal takedown. Using stealth and the non-lethal approach has benefits, fewer rats and weepers. Some people react favorably and the final outcome is not as dark.
Social so, for the high
tell Flatjaw I'm in here.
See the noble
He's
Lord
gotta get me out.
His head chopped off.
Burn this place to the ground.
That is us betting on the dogfights.
You're out. Good for you. Cut some throats.
Attention.
Let me out.
Solitary
I've got 3 days before they cut my head off.
Unless accompanied by an officer of the watch. Escort through the solitary wing.
We can pick up the body and hold it.
In advance with 1 week's notice.
And throw.
Shut up.
And we gotta hide. They don't know that the other guy left his post. I was not paying attention.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution.
Whoa, hey, what is this?
Restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
They're gonna sound the alarm now. That's not good. Anyway, the one thing that I didn't like about the combat is it's kind of it's real easy to get disoriented if you're not completely keeping track of what's going on. You can take a pistol. Let's do that. Health potions are used in combat as needed. The store is locked. You can peer through keyholes and such. And you can heal yourself by eating items that you find.
Did I tell you about the time I almost caught that guy who killed the Empress? You're such a chump.
All right. And there's lots of treasure to be found. So I actually thought that I found quite a bit of treasure in my run through of this the first time. It turns out I only found about half of it. I'm not the most observant person in the world, but... gotta go down here and get the key from this guy. I'll talk about the rats later. Choke him out. You can loot. So I got the walkway key. So the rats will go for dead bodies, and they make noise, and in packs, they actually hurt you. So you don't want that. You don't want that. Open the door. Money. A coin of 5. I like the little icon. Pretty much anything you pick up that's not a direct item that's used to accomplish an objective is worth something.
Attention. The solitary wing is off limits to maintenance crews. Unless accompanied by an officer of the watch. Escort through the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance.
Yard. Let's pick up your treasure. Rats are fine in small quantities for the most part. But you don't want to let them get bigger, like in bigger packs. This place does not look friendly. I look down on corporal punishment. Duty officer's report. So you can find notes and things that lead to more of the story and kind of the backfill on some of what these people are up to. Keep the torture under control if the guy dies.
Corvo's unconscious again. Though he's taken more punishment than the 2 men we brought in for interrogation. When he wakes, we'll start again. Having him sign the confession for the murder isn't critical, but it might be useful to us later. The assassination of an empress is not a trivial matter.
No, no, it's not. Alright, so this is where the bomb's at. As per our objective, in a safe that's not even open or locked. That's a good way to be. Plant the explosives.
Ackworth, you lazy slug. Did you patrol the yard?
Sorry, not yet. I was gonna report that boiler leak from yesterday.
Forget it.
Attention, the solitary wing is off limits to maintenance crews. Unless
accompanied
by an officer of the watch. Escort through the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance, with 1 week's notice.
I know you're somewhere around here.
No, you don't. Feels like there's still somebody in here. So the leaning is kind of annoying because you have to position yourself in such a way that you could potentially not be in the right position to lean without having to move and get yourself spotted. Gonna hang out back here.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
He's going to see me.
Maybe wind or something.
I watch you.
No, no stupid goddamn devil son of a gun. That's it.
I'll get you.
Let me know if you want to take my patrol.
Attention. The solitary wing is off limits to maintenance crew, unless accompanied by an officer of the watch. Escort through the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance, with 1 week's notice.
Ha! You little bastard!
Got a prowler on the loose.
You're goddamn right. Alright, you can pickpocket enemies. As well. Which is kind of a nice touch. We'll see that in just a second here. This is sort of what I was talking about with the not being able to see totally.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
Whoa, hey, none of that now.
Huh?
Oh, he got me. You just put an enemy off balance. Now press R1 to perform a counterattack. And there you go. So, I fucked up that route the first time, as well, which kind of sucks, but anyway, that's sort of what you can do to get through an area if you have no other means to do so. Sort of unfortunate, but whatever. Gotta pick up money first. And, you can heal yourself, pick up some bullets. I don't like open doors. It's bad for business. There's a dude in here. Guess not. He must have come out when he heard the ruckus. The ruckus. Alright, let's pick up some crap. There's probably a dude out there. Hardcore dude out there. Gotta wait till he comes back. He makes all that noise and makes it hard to hear what the other guy's doing. Solitary wing? I thought it said sanitary wing. This is the one thing that sucks if you are playing a game that has stealth and you're not one of those people that's patient enough for it. Is it does take a long time for stuff to happen because of these stupid enemies. I'll get you. That was kind of... That was very poorly planned. The thing that you can do when you take out an enemy with the stealth and you try to hold him unconscious is you can hold down the square button to carry the body, but if you don't press it fast enough, he drops the body and then you have to wait for him to regroup, basically. He reconfigures his weapons and everything before you can actually pick it up, and sometimes that split second of behavior is all you need for an enemy to see what you're doing, and then you kind of just have to improvise, and that's what we did, so there you go. So screw you for that. Alright, plant the bomb. And run our asses out of here. Run away! We're going to get spotted. And jump! If they see you doing this, they'll shoot you. See? We've escaped to the sewers. And that's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna escape. And I don't want to stay in prison, so I'm going. And although we're not quite done with the mission, I think this is actually going to be where I cut off now. So we've escaped the prison and reach the second portion of this mission, where basically now all we have to do is get out to the point where our mysterious contact had said to meet, so that we can further on the story. And one thing that I didn't really touch on, which is actually one of the more important aspects of this game, is what happens after you finish the mission. So what we'll learn once we escape from the sewers and meet up with the mysterious contact is it'll take us across the river, and we'll end up meeting a set of characters that will serve as our mission hub, so to speak. So there's a place where you hang out, you have a place to sleep, and you know, gather yourself before taking on each mission. And there's some people that will actually do some things for you. In which you can spend all of the stuff that you've been looting on upgrades and gadgets and things to make Corvo stronger and to improve his skills. So once you start learning how to use magic and things like that, so that there's, you know, opportunities for you to improve that way. But pretty much whatever you do with any of the treasures that you find is that you can turn that into items that can be sold on the black market, which is essentially just earning money for it. And you can pay to have certain gadgets upgraded or get new gadgets or things that you can do to make your missions easier. So I thought that was kind of cool. That's sort of an aspect that was taken from Thief. It's a really, really nice touch. And it's one of those things where, yeah, I forgot to mention it, but it's also kind of one of those things where the game leads you into it, you know, pretty early on. So it's not something that's completely overlooked, but it is one of the more RPG-like features of the game, because it allows you to specify what you spend your money on in order to improve certain aspects of Corvo's character. So if you favor stealth, you can upgrade more stealth type gadgets and powers. If you favor more just going in Rambo style and killing everything, you can do that too. So you definitely have your pick of the crop there, depending on your style of play. And it's just something that I've always really liked in games, and consequently always makes it really hard for me to play because I'm so indecisive. But anyway, that's about it. So I'm going to go ahead and cut off now at the part where you escape Cold Ridge Prison and have to make it through the sewers and get out and cross the river. So if you really want to see that, I'm just going to have to say that you go ahead and buy this game, because it's definitely worth playing through. I've always been a fan of the stealth genre, even though I am not the most coordinated person when it comes to playing games like this. I tend to screw up really easily. It's one of those ones where it's not totally harsh on you for screwing up, which I think is a really good thing. There's a lot of stealth games that I've played where they beat you down for screwing up, and it makes the game frustrating because you pretty much have to behave like a perfectionist. You know, Splinter Cell was always one of those games where you had to employ a lot of stealth in order to get through, but there were portions of it where you didn't really have any choice, and the game wasn't impossible if you had everyone on your ass, but it was one of those ones where obviously your life was a lot easier if you were more quiet about things. So that being said, even frustration factor aside, I'm a sucker for these types of games. I really like the ability to find different ways to do things, even if it's not the most obvious. And, you know, I've played through several of them on my channel, and people have always pointed out new things that I haven't tried, or things that were probably obvious to me if I had been playing without recording or whatnot. You know, so anything like that is possible in a game like this. So definitely worth your play. I'm definitely going to be finishing this one, exploring all it has to offer. I really think that Arkane did a really good job with this, and I have high hopes. So I recommend it to you, and hope you check it out. And I hope you enjoyed this episode of Back of the Box, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.